Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So this channel, Every Data Science, is all about trying to learn the different concepts in law data science by practicing a lot of questions. In this video, I'm going to solve this question on Stratascratch regarding bikes last used, both using Python as well as MySQL, and try to walk you through how we can develop solutions to such problems. The difficulty level of this question is easy, and this question has been asked in LYFT interviews. Okay, let's jump right in. The question reads, find the last time each bike was in use. Output both the bike number and the date timestamp of the bike's last use, that is the date time the bike was returned. Order the results by bikes that were most recently used, right? So basically, we are given a data frame called DC bike share quarter 1 2012, and expected output is a pandas data frame with two different columns, bike number and last used, in a manner that, you know, we need to arrange this by last use in decreasing manner, right? So if we inquire this data frame DC bike share quarter 1 2012, right? So if you look at it, like, you have a lot of information, right? The duration of the ride in seconds, start time, station, start terminal, end time, right? Same information, bike number, rider type, ID, etc. So what we need to do is, for each of the bike number, right? So for each of the bike number, we need to find out the last time this bike was used. So basically, this is the, you know, end time, right? So for different bike, like, same bikes can be used for different rides, right? So out of all those rides, like, when was this bike latest used? So what we can do is, we can group by the bike number and find the maximum value in the end time column, right? Because that is going to be the last used one, right? So when you find the maximum time, so that is the last used for each bike number, and then we can return the certain columns that we are required to do. So what I'm saying is, from this data frame called DC bike share quarter 1 2012, right, what we can do is, we can group by, right? So group by the bike number column, right? So group by bike number, right? And then what we can do is, since we also want this as a column, right? So we don't want this to be just index, so we write as index is equal to false, and then in the column end time, we need to get the maximum value, right? Because that is going to demonstrate, like, this is the last time this bike was used. Let me run this. Okay, so if you look at, right, so you have different bike numbers and the last time they were used. Now, once we have this, then what we can do is, if you look in the expected output, right, so this should be renamed as last used, right? So what we can do is, we can go ahead and rename it. So we can write dot rename, right? And then what do we need to rename? Columns. And then we can provide the key value pair. So it needs to be changed from end time, and we need to change to last used, right? Let me run this. Let's see what we are getting. So if you see, the name of the column has been changed. Also, the question says the order the results by bikes that were most recently used. So basically, we need to sort by this column. So what we can do is, we can write dot sort values, right? And then by which column? Last used, right? Last used, and it should be in descending manner. So we write ascending is equal to false, right? Okay, so let me run this. Okay, so now if you look at it, right, our output is same as expected output. Let me go ahead and submit it to see if it passes all the test cases. So yeah, everything is green, and this is how we do it. Again, not a difficult question. Now let's see how this solution looks like in MySQL. If you look at it, same question, right, expected output is same as well, if you inquire this table DC bike share quarter 1 2022, you have the same column, same values, all that, right? So here what we need to do is, for each of the bike number, again, we need to find out the maximum, right, or basically the last used part, right? So what we can do is, we can rank this, right? So different uses of a particular bike, we can rank this using either row number, rank, dense rank. I'm going to use row number as a window function. So what we can do is, we can write row number, right? And then for each of the bike, right? So we write over, and then partition by the bike number, right? And then order by end time in decreasing manner, because so that, you know, the latest one comes up first, and we alias this as rank. Right, let me run this. Let's see what we are getting. So now if you look at it, right, so for different bikes, like, which one was the latest use? So once we have this, then what we can do is we can store this in a common table expression. So we can write with CTE as, and then this entire thing goes into parentheses, right? And then what we need to do is from this common table expression, we are only going to keep those rows where rank is equal to 1. Why? Because we have ranked in descending manner of time for each bike number, right? So when rank is equal to 1 means it is the latest use of that particular bike. So from this common table expression, wherever you have the latest use, you return the two columns, right? So you return the bike number and you return the end time, but we need to alias this as last used, right? Because that is what we have in the output. So we write as last used, and then we also need to order this by last used in descending manner. Okay, so let me run this. Let's see what we are getting. So now if you look at it, right, so our output is same as expected output. Let me go ahead and submit it to see if it passes all the test cases. So yeah, again, everything is green, and this is how we do it. Again, not a very difficult question. All we had to do was, you know, try to identify that, okay, which one is the last use of each of the bikes. And once we had that, then what we did was we simply, you know, returned those two columns that were required in the output and ordered by the last use in descending manner, right? So yeah, this is how we do it. Let me know if there is a better way or a more efficient way you can think of to solve this question. Let the solution be in the comment section below. And until then, I will see you guys in the next video.